I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you the energy engineering. In the energy engineering, I am focusing over the hydrograph and flow duration curve. This is the problem they are given it. This is a monthly discharge. This is a month and discharge they are given it. We have to draw the hydrograph. And consider the scale. 1 cm is equal in terms of month and y-axis in terms of 100 meter cube per second. First, I will draw light in terms of month, this part. This is January, February, March, April, May, June. As per this one, you have to write June, July, August, September, October, November, December. December. Next, I will write this in terms of written in terms of month, the discharge will be in terms of 100 mm. Now it will be in terms of month. Month. Now discharge 100, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1000, 1100, 1200, because maximum is 1200. Now, I will draw the hydrograph. First, January 100, January 100, it is 100. Next, February 225, 225 is here, 225. Approximate here 225 for February, 225, March 300, this is the March, March 300, 300, next April 600, April 600, next May 750, May 750, May 750, June 800, June 800, 800, June 800, next July 1000, July 1000, 1000, August 1200, August 1200, September 900, September 9, September 900, October 600, October 600, November 400, November 400, December 200, December 200, this completes your hydrograph, 200. This is the hydrograph. By using this one, you have to draw the hydrograph. Now, by seeing this hydrograph, you have to draw this table. It contains discharge, length of the time in month and percentage of time. This is A, this is B, and this should be B divided by 12 into 100. 12 is nothing but in terms of month. Okay, now I have to write in increasing order from smaller to larger value. I have written here 100 to 200 in an increasing order. If suppose, assume it, if 300 is in the three times, it is repeated three times, but while writing here, you have to select only one time. For example, if 800 is thrice they have written or twice they have written it, but while writing in the discharge, you have to write in a single. That is 800 you have to write. Okay, now 100 for 100.
Sorry, I don't know that.
100. 100. This is the 100. You have to see the graph. 100. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. it should be 12. Next, 200. Here, this is the 200, count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is 11. 225. 225. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is 10. 300. Now 300 is here. Count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 times. 400. 400 is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. 600. This is 600. Now 600 is twice here. How to match? How to count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. This is an important part here. 600 is nothing but 7 times. You have to count these two. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, 750. 750. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 800. 800. 1, 2, 3, 4. 900. 1, 2, 3. 1000 twice, 1200 once. This complete. By seeing the hydrograph, you have to write the length of the time in terms of month. Now, how to measure the time in percentage? Just you have to root this B, 12 divided by 12 into 100. It will be 100%. 100% in terms of percentage. Next, 11 divided by 12 into 100. You will get 91.7. Next, 10 divided by 12 into 100. You will get 83.33. Next, 9 divided by 12 into 100. You will get 75. 8 divided by 12 into 100. You will get 66.7. Now 7 divided by 12 into 100, you will get 58.3. 5 divided by 12 into 100, you will get 41.7. 4 divided by 12 into 100, 33.3. 3 divided by 12 into 100, 25. 2 divided by 12 into 100, 16.7. 1 divided by 12 into 100, 8.3. Now, by seeing this one, you have to draw discharge of such percent of time. That is flow duration curve. This is your hydrograph. Hydrograph. Now I am drawing the flow duration curve. Flow duration curve I am writing here. By seeing this one, I am draw the flow duration curve. Now how to draw the flow duration curve? First, I will consider the scale here. I will consider the scale. Scale. 1 centimeter is equal to 10% x-axis, y-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meter cube per second. I will draw here by seeing this one. Now in terms of percentage I am writing here. First this one I will write. Now this is 100, I will start from 10, 0, 10%, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 100. This is a fixed question in exam. This is in terms of percentage of time. Next, this one will be in terms of discharge, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1000, 110, 1200, discharge, meter cube per second, okay. Now, first, 100, for 100 it is 100, cut and mark. Next, for 200 it is 91.7, for 200 it is 91.7. Next, for 225 it is 83.33, 225, I am considering this is a 225. It is 80.33 around here. Next, 300, for 375 means it appears here. For 400 it is 66.7, for 466 is here. For 600, it is 58.3. For 600, 58 is here. Approximately here, 58, okay. For 750, it is 41.1. For 750, 750 means here, 750, it is 41. 40 means 41. 41 is here. Next, for 800 it is 33.33, 33 means approximately here. For 900 it is 25, for 900 is 25, it's 25. For 1000 it is 16.7, for 1000 16.7. For 1200, 8.33. No, draw the curve. This is a flow duration curve. Now, how to find out the average value? Average is very simple. Add this one. Everything you have to add and divide by 12. 100 plus 225 plus 300 plus 600 plus 750 plus 800 plus 1000 plus 1200 plus 900 plus 600 plus 400 plus 200 divided by 12, you will get average. Average will be around 58. This is the average, approximate. This is the average flow. 58.9.58 meter cube per second. This graph we called as a flow duration curve. And last graph we called as a hydrograph. The average is here, approximate. That is 589.58 meter cube per second average. This is the hydrograph, and this will be in terms of discharge, meter cube per second. This is the flow hydrograph. This is the flow deviation curve. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.